I love you.
I know.
It's the motherfucking Eagle Double G.
Snoop Dogg.
Welcome everybody to
I Love You.
I know. This is the signature podcast from the Prolonged Engagement. You can go to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/theprolongedengagementshow, or you can go to our website, theprolongedengagement.com. There you can find links to our YouTube channel as well as all of the podcasting services that we are on. You can find this show in video and audio format. And we come at you every Monday at noon.
Or close to noon.
Or close to noon.
Depending upon how stupid YouTube is being.
It's normally not YouTube that's the problem.
Oh, it's your computer?
It's normally my computer. I'm running it off of a six-year-old computer. And it takes 5 hours to render a video. So yeah,
and there have been times that we've slept with that damn thing on.
Oh, yeah, I've slept multiple times with the thing just going. Because it takes a couple hours to put together a 50-minute video, which is fucking ridiculous.
Yeah.
But, or that's my case. And it's not like this thing is it's getting slow, but, you know, 2.2 gigahertz, it's a quad-core processor. I mean, it should not have any problem doing anything. It's just old.
But excuse me.
I digress. So our main topic for the week is going to be indie games.
Yeah.
And these small little experiences that you get nowadays. But before then, let's get into our shtick.
Yeah.
So my little story here today was, it's a video that I already showed you.
Which one?
It's the Jimmy Fallon video. The one where they unveiled the Switch like live.
Yes!
So if you haven't seen this video, and I am not putting it up.
Nope.
No more NBC Universal crap ever.
We didn't know. We love them so much.
I love it. And I love Universal Studios, but... You know, just let me put it. How many people watch this show? Like 5 a week?
Maybe. If we're lucky.
We had 3 views last week.
Ooh.
All 3. It was great. still hasn't beaten the Markovs one. That's 177 going strong.
Oh,
so.
Yeah.
It's done.
I told
it's
you, though. Done, though. I told you, though.
What?
We need to just do haunts. Because haunts are awesome.
Our haunt... shows were the most successful ones out of the entire run. So that's not true. The first time that we talked about PSVR, that was a good spike as well. But it's because it was like just coming out, and that was our first impressions that we talked about. But
no, but I've already told you we need to do haunt videos.
Oh yeah, definitely.
That's something we're really passionate about.
And I'd like to do more of them. But
oh, it's fun. I love getting scared.
Getting there. Anyway, so the video, if you haven't seen it yet,
it's cute.
The Late Show with Jimmy Fallon. And
I love that show.
So they had Reggie Fils-Aimé come on, who is the, he's the American you know.
Nintendo guy. But they also had...
Oh, they had
near and dear to our heart.
Yeah, they had Miyamoto there as well.
Yes,
who is sitting in the audience, so
and not understand a single word that's going on in the.
I think that he can understand English. He just can't speak it well. I think he has a hard time articulating.
Well, yeah, he's like.
But I mean, he's Miyamoto. He doesn't need.
He doesn't
to speak
need
English.
To. He doesn't need to.
He's got Reggie there to speak English for him. So, Reggie Fils-Aimé has got to know Japanese, right?
Hey,
he has to
he
know,
has
right?
To.
There's
That's
no
all
way.
I can think.
There's no way that he doesn't,
oh, yeah.
know it, right? Okay.
I would be shocked if he didn't.
I would be. I would be definitely shocked if he did not know Japanese.
Yeah.
But I digress.
Now, if he wanted in on the show today, so
whatever. So Reggie's there, and he's talking. The first thing that they bring up is
Mario Run,
Super Mario Run, which is going to be an iOS game.
December 15th.
December 15th. Oh yeah, that's this Thursday.
Yeah,
it's that, upcoming Thursday.
That I am waiting impatiently for it.
Oh, I'm buying the fuck out of it.
Oh, yeah. I'm a huge Mario fan, and you know that.
I'm stoked. I'm totally stoked.
I'm a Nintendo fangirl.
Totally stoked.
You didn't do the opening for this one. The segment. You didn't do the look what I found.
Look what I... Oh, no. That's not working.
Where's my effect? I don't know. You don't have to do it. You can do
look
it later.
Look what I found. No, it's not working. Why is it not working?
Oh, dear.
Oh, there it is. I put it in the subs only.
Oh.
So. Look what I found. Remember, I was recording something for you.
I know you did.
And so I didn't want the... I needed it to be in the subs because I didn't want it to reverb.
Everything, on the, just me.
Everything. I just wanted it to reverb you, so.
That's yeah, why I it know. Didn't work.
Okay, so... I'm sorry. So he's doing Super Mario Run. So Reggie gives him the iPhone, and so he's playing it, and he's like, oh, well, I'll show you what to do, and, you know, we'll get you, if you're doing real well, we'll get you to this star or whatever, and so,
the invincibility, you know, star.
Jimmy Fallon is, like, totally freaking out while playing this. He's like, oh, my God, rah, rah, rah.
He seems like such a nerd. Oh, yeah. Makes me so happy.
Like, I think he's a total Nintendo nerd, though.
Yes, like me.
He's a total Nintendo nerd, you and Tim Gettys.
I'm such a Nintendo nerd. I love Nintendo so much.
I do, too, but it sucks when they don't give us good hardware. When they give us something like the Wii U, and it's like
there is nothing wrong with the Wii U.
There's everything wrong with the Wii U. The Wii U was an afterthought in their mind.
No, it wasn't.
Nintendo fumbled with that thing, Sarah. I'm sorry, but Nintendo fumbled with it.
I love it. I love it.
It sold like 2 million units worldwide. That's abysmal.
I liked it. I like it.
That's abysmal.
I get to play Pikmin. My Pikmin 3.
Okay. But if you could play those games on a PS4, would you have not liked it a lot better?
Yes.
There you go. That's my thing. Wind it's Waker. Not good hardware. The software is what sells Nintendo. But now we have the Switch, which is what we will finally have hardware
so
and software that goes
excited.
Together. I'm
sorry,
you know, I hope to God that this ends up.
I will well, and after what you told me about Animal Crossing from the original GameCube.
Yes, I'm so excited about
that.
The
original Luigi's Mansion,
mm-hmm.
which is still the best.
They say that they're going to bring GameCube ports to the Switch. The ones that they have rumored to be, you know, going on right now mm-hmm. are Animal Crossing, Luigi's Mansion,
mm-hmm.
Super Mario Sunshine,
yeah.
and Super Smash Bros. Melee, which was, oh my God. If
you know what
talk about... Talk about a smash. Melee was it.
Do you want to know what I would like fall over for?
What?
Mario Kart Double Dash.
That would be awesome. Especially because you could play with you could play that one with those with the two Oh man.
Nintendo, please
give me Double Dash.
Please.
Please give me Double Dash.
Oh my God.
That's all
please.
I need in my life. I need Super Smash Brothers Melee.
She's even asking for it.
And
Elfie,
Super Mario and Mario
Double
Kart
Dash.
Double Dash.
See, Elfie's even asking for Double Dash.
And then after that, give me Billy Hatcher and the Giant Egg.
Oh no!
Yes,
that was a third party.
No, it wasn't.
Wasn't?
No, it's made by Sonic Team. Oh. It's a Sega game. Get the hell out of here.
That is not Nintendo.
I don't care. I need it. Billy Hatcher and the Giant Egg, and Super Monkey Ball. That's all I need. And my life will be, I will just play Switch for the rest of my life if I have those four games. That'll be it. And I could die happy. I could really die happy at that point.
And then he plays the Switch and he plays Breath of the Wild.
Yeah, so after he plays Super Mario Run, he's really, really excited. And Reggie's like, oh, we have something else to sell you. My name is Reggie Fillamy.
And he's going, no, you didn't. No,
and he's like, oh my God, he's in the Switch. Oh my God. And so Reggie, pulls this box off, and he's like,
pulls the question block off.
We're gonna let you know. We're gonna let you play a game. He's like, oh, tell me it's not the news album. Oh my god. And so they actually,
I would have been the same way. News album.
So they start off with Reggie playing on the pro controller, and then he says, oh well, this is a great thing. He said, if you're playing and then you have to go to rehearsal, all you have to do is click it off. And so he pulls a switch off of the thing and hands it to Jimmy Fallon. And Jimmy Fallon is literally, he is jizzing in his pants at this point.
He looks like he's shaking.
He is shaking. He's
shaking,
holding
so excited. He's shaking.
And so he's like, I know everything about this. He's like, there's a kickstand in the back. And he's like pulling the kickstand open and puts it down. And he's like, oh, and then you can pull these things off. And you can play two-player games. Oh, my God. And he's like,
it made me
out
so happy how nerdy he was.
It was really, it's a really fantastic video. I'll put it in the description below.
Yeah.
And you can watch it for yourself. Watch it for yourself. I'll put it in the description and also make a card. You can click over on the card.
Yeah.
But
please come back.
They don't want to.
They won't end up coming back.
They
never come back.
What's our median watch time? 2 minutes.
A
we're
minute.
Good. All right. So,
and then my story.
We're never gonna go anywhere, right?
I want to. Because I love you guys.
Yours
I love you all.
Is what?
Well, actually, I chose two. Mm-hmm. My first one was a giant leatherback sea turtle seen in New Zealand.
Mm-hmm.
They say it must have been at least 6.5 feet long.
I figured I'm just going to put a link to it instead of playing right now.
Okay.
Yeah. I'll just put a link to that one. You could use that one.
Well, I want to.
Because it's a Facebook video, so I wasn't going to. Yeah. I normally put those videos in the middle here.
Yeah.
But
it's super cute because he is very large.
Mm-hmm.
Or she. I couldn't see. And, but he's just kind of chilling out. And hi guys, I'm here. What's going on? But it's the largest leatherback sea turtle I've ever seen.
Mm-hmm.
Even the leatherback sea turtles are the largest sea turtles in the world, reaching a maximum of 2,000 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
This guy was larger than 2,000 pounds.
What do you look like?
He, take the table,
mm-hmm.
double it, both out and that way.
That's what, 8 feet, you think?
He looked to me like he was almost 7 to 8 feet.
Wow, that's humongous.
Yes.
They normally only get up to six, normally, right?
6 foot is their largest. The new people of New Zealand were saying he was 6.5, but I was like, that sounds kind of small for that guy.
He might have only been, yeah.
Yeah. But well, the way they were filming
it. They're from New Zealand. I mean, come on. Come on.
But it was huge, and he's just chill. He was showing.
I mean, what are New Zealanders good for?
A lot.
Yeah, that's very true. I mean, Lord of the Rings.
Yeah.
That's good stuff.
Yeah. But,
I've never seen Lord of the Rings.
I know, neither have I.
I shouldn't watch it at some point.
We should.
John was like, you've never seen Lord of the Rings? He's like, I have the extended edition on Blu-ray. We'll watch all three. It'll take 12 hours. I'm like, all right, let's do it.
We'll do it. Someday. Yeah,
we'll have to do it at some point.
And then I had a second one because you told me it was a Facebook video, so I looked up the second one.
Mm-hmm.
The second one is of two Alaskan Malamutes who are all excited because grandma's there for Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
And they can smell her, but she's not in the room.
Yeah.
So one of them ends up jumping into the air, sniffing the ceiling to find grandma. And so when they open the door to go upstairs, they immediately go and find her.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's really cute.
And it's so cute. And it's all Christmassy. And
it's all that Christmas goodness.
Yeah.
I'll put the card up there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Christmas happiness.
So you want to get into our main topic here?
Yes.
All right. So we've been, in between Watch Dogs 2 and Pokemon and all that good stuff, mm-hmm. we ended up doing a few of these indie titles.
Yeah.
Some of them we got for free on PS Plus. Others, we were like, oh, let's
play
go
that.
Ahead and
it
buy.
Sounds good.
So the three that I'm talking about are Everybody's Gone to the Rapture.
Yeah.
So that was actually free for in November for PS Plus subscribers. Firewatch.
Yes.
By Monto Santo. Monto Santo. Campo Santo.
Campo Santo.
And Inside, which was made by Dead Play.
I think that was it.
Is that it?
They're the same guys who did Limbo.
Yes, same guys that did Limbo. Let's look up.
Inside. You're going to fall off again, and then I'm going to laugh.
All right, let's see what... Made by Play Dead. There you go.
Didn't you say Dead Play?
I did. Play Dead. Yeah, these were the guys that made...
Limbo.
That made Limbo. It's got a 92% on Metacritic. Like, this is
It's a really nice game.
It's a really just quite an incredible experience. It was up for Game of the Year this year. In many different ways. We watched the Game Awards last weekend, and it was up for Game of the Year there. It was up for, like, art direction. It was up for a lot of things. And
I agree with a couple of them.
I'm telling you, it definitely deserved it.
Oh, yeah.
Even though I can't exactly understand what happened, but, you know, we read a lot of things.
Theories and such.
Theories and such. And I like the theories that they came up with. Oh, yeah. Like, and I don't want to spoil anything because it really is an, you know.
It's one of those things that you have to go and play yourself.
It's an emotional journey. So you start off in the woods. And
as a child.
Yeah. And you play as like a child.
Mm-hmm.
And he jumps off a cliff.
And you're just running the entire time.
And the and whole solving thing puzzles. Is it's a 2D side scroller.
2D, 3D side scroller.
No, I guess it could be called a 3D side scroller because it's got depth to it, but you can only go in two directions.
Yeah.
So it starts off and you see like some people loaded onto a truck. You're like, what the heck is going on here? And you continue on and they have it to where like dogs come and chase you. And of course the dogs can run faster than you do. You have one speed and one speed only in this game. So if the dogs catch you, they freaking catch you and they will kill you.
On sight.
If people find you, if they have a gun, they will shoot you. If they otherwise, they will come and they will strangle you. Everything in the game kills you.
It's always insta-kill.
Everything kills you. Now, granted, there are checkpoints that, you know, you don't exactly see. It's if you die in a certain part, it just puts you back at another part.
Yeah.
So, but then it came out to be like dogs chase you and you have to figure out ways of
tricking
the dog into, you know, into not catching you at a certain time. Well, you come on. If she's going to do that the whole freaking time, then she's going to have to go down. Because now.
What?
Now you're not even talking because she's licking your face.
I just can't talk when she gets close to
her. I wonder if the people on the MP3 can
on audio can hear her.
Because I can hear it.
You can hear it? Mm-hmm. So yeah, they're going to hear it.
Licking your face. Good God.
Do you want to get down?
But... The other ones that get into it is that it's kind of like this post-apocalyptic world.
Kind of?
I kind of see it that way.
Okay. Yeah, I agree with you.
It may not... Let's not say post-apocalyptic. We might say like on the edge of apocalyptic.
Yeah.
Like, you know, we've gotten to a point where, you know, like there's certain amounts of humans that could survive and others that can't. And so these are, you know, they're trying to genetically do something, you know. No idea what they're doing, but they're doing something.
Yeah.
They have these machines that, you know, that can spot you and...
Spear you and kill you.
When they spot you, they spear you with this, like...
coil thingy. Medicine.
Coil thing. And it stabs you and instantly kills you, and then you just ragdoll back.
Yeah.
Because it has a spring on it.
Yeah.
And you're sitting there like, whoa, like, this is some seriously,
intense shit.
I mean, the deaths in this game are insanely violent. Yes. Like, violent.
Point where it's uncomfortable.
I'm not saying, like, it's like Walking Dead violent.
No.
But... The way that the game looks and the way that it plays and the way that it feels makes those deaths really, really
intense,
striking. Yes. It almost takes you out of the environment. But then again, I feel
like it's appropriate, actually.
Absolutely. I feel like it was absolutely appropriate. Yeah. When you look at that, and how long did it take us to get through that thing?
Two, maybe 3 hours.
It only took us a few hours, right? No, it didn't take us, it wasn't two. Maybe it is probably five or six.
Oh, okay.
Because we played it for like the whole day. Okay. It was probably 5 or 6 hours to get through the whole game.
Maybe. Firewatch was the same way.
Yeah, Firewatch took probably six or, you know, somewhere between 6 and 8, probably. Maybe.
I really think you're giving them
more time. We could have played that game for a hell of a lot longer.
Oh, yeah.
Just because you don't have... You could have just explored. We kind of, you know, went story point to story point. Because I wanted to know what freaking happened. But with Inside, yeah, I can... If you have not played Inside yet,
you should
have to do it. It's like nothing I've played before. Really. Yeah. Really, really.
I'd also say play Firewatch.
And absolutely play Firewatch.
Because Firewatch was very different. It was an experience. There wasn't much action to it.
No. There weren't even any, like, there's no quick time events.
No.
It's just climb here, walk over here. Can run, you can, you know, chop down a tree.
Yeah.
You know, there's some little puzzly things involved there.
Yeah.
But you know, it's not huge. It's not like, you know, oh, man, how do I get through this? It's really it's easy going. But the coolest thing about Firewatch is that it's in first person, and you hear the voice of the person that you're playing as. Yes. And you get to choose
what
he says, but the only interaction that your character has is over a walkie-talkie the entire game.
Yeah.
And I think
you only see maybe one other person.
Yeah, one other person in the whole... Oh no, there's three people that you can see. The two girls that you see at the beginning
of the
game.
That's right.
And then the one guy that you see.
At the very end.
At the beginning of the game. You see him with a flashlight.
Oh.
Other than that, you don't see anybody.
Oh, I was talking about the final person you see.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Then there's four people that you see. But you never see you don't like hardly converse with these people.
No.
I guess the girl you do.
The girls, kind
but of. But the main thing with... The main thing of the game is that you're conversing with this other Firewatch person who is technically your boss.
And you talk with her for a while.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, the two of you gain a relationship together. Mm-hmm.
You can almost take it in a romantic
stance. Yeah, you could. I was kind of pushing it in that direction.
Not as hard as I felt you could have.
I think that you could have really, really pushed it. Mm-hmm. You could have just been totally open and like ready to move on. You know, the game starts off with you finding out it's in the late 80s, right?
Yes.
And you find out that the main character's wife is suffering from Alzheimer's.
Early onset.
Yeah, so she was like dementia. She started off with dementia.
Yeah,
right?
Early onset dementia.
At like 41 or something like that. And then
it changes into Alzheimer's.
Kind of, you know, morphed itself into Alzheimer's. And so...
And it's heartbreaking.
The reason that he takes on this job is to kind of, you know, like re-find himself.
Yeah.
You know, kind of center himself. Because his wife's parents actually take her
back home,
back to Australia.
Yeah.
This takes place in Colorado and take her to Australia to, you know, take care of her.
Yeah. I wonder. Cause
I think, cause he says that, you know, the parents never liked him, you know, never thought that he was good enough.
I wonder how that would have changed.
If what?
Because you chose to keep her at home.
Yeah, the beginning of the game gives you all these options of saying, like, and it's all in text.
Yeah.
And it's just...
there's no audio, spoken verbal audio for the entire beginning of the game.
Yeah, and it's just in text, and it says, like, this you happened. Meet. You meet. This is what you say. This happened. This is what you decide. And those decisions that you make there, they affect the different things that you can say in your conversations with...
Dahlia.
With Dahlia. Is it Delia? Frick, I don't remember.
I think it's Delia.
Delilah?
Maybe it's Delilah.
Delilah.
Is it Delilah?
Ah, crap. Now I'm going to look it up.
I think it's Delilah, actually. Yes, it is Delilah.
Is it Delilah?
Yeah.
Hold on, let me... Delilah.
God, I haven't heard that in years.
Yeah, because we don't listen to 107.7 and... I wonder if Delilah's even up here. I bet you she is. She's everywhere, right?
I have no idea.
Fucking Delilah. Did you ever used to listen to that when you were little?
Oh, all the time.
Did your mom listen to it or something?
Yeah, my
or
parents
was
did.
Was it your grandmother?
It was my dad.
Delilah, yep. It is Delilah.
Yeah.
Yeah. In the game, yes, Delilah. Yeah. Not just...
No.
Delilah!
No, it was my dad who listened to it, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, that would be your daddy, wouldn't it? I listened to it in the car. This was before everyone...
It would be in the car, like, driving home from school or something, and my dad would pick me up, and we listened to Delilah driving home.
But this was before my family went over to the, you know, like, only Z88.3 for a while.
Yeah.
Oh, God. If you don't live in Orlando, you don't know, but Z88.3...
You have no idea what we're talking about.
Z88.3 is that's the Christian radio station... So they say positive hits. It's like
positive hits. Z88.3.
Your mother still listens to that crap. It's the same music. Not a single. I haven't listened to that radio station in 12 years, and I turn it on and it's the same music I heard 12 years ago.
And not just that, they've become very political.
They've always been political.
Well.
They've always been political.
Yes, but
and
I never...
And they have people like James Dobson on there. Who's a big, like, anti-porn, anti-masturbation guy.
I wonder if that's where Mom gets all her football.
James Dobson, you know that. James Dobson was the guy that frickin' Jeffrey Dahmer came out. No.
That's right.
He was like,
that's him.
Yeah.
Porn made me do it.
Like,
Jeffrey, no,
you
are
Dahmer.
Honest to God sick.
You're a goddamn sicko.
Ugh. You can lay back down. It's okay.
But that's who they have on Z80 was James Dobson. Like, get the hell out of here.
No, the only reason that Jeffrey Dahmer even... No, was it Ted Bundy or Jeffrey Dahmer?
I don't remember who it was. It was either Jeffrey or Ted.
I think it might have been Ted, actually.
It might have been Ted.
It was Ted, because Ted's the one that said porn made him do it.
Oh, okay. It was. I've got... I am not the serial killer person. You are.
I know. You got me confused.
Yeah, it was my fault. But... Yeah, I'm going to have to plug this damn thing in.
Okay.
My battery only lasts for...
10 minutes.
It's going to go dead in 15.
Oh.
So, if any of you have an extra $3,400 just lying around, I would love to take it off your hands and get me a nice new shiny laptop. One that is not, you know, I mean, listen to this thing. Can you hear that? I mean, it just the fan never turns off on this thing anymore.
Do you want to sit here?
It's constantly going. I'm tempted to use your computer for all this stuff.
Yeah.
Because you know, mine's gonna just keel over one day.
Yeah.
Battery is not charging. That's how much power it's using. The battery is not charging, so it's gonna stay at 25% this whole time.
That's
good God.
Bothersome.
When I use Final Cut sometimes, it'll go from 99 to 95. Like, it'll use that much power consumption.
Fuck.
Yeah. It's insane. At any rate. What were we talking about? We were talking about Z88.3 and how Toby Mac is cool.
No.
No?
No.
Delilah.
Yes, Fuck the duck. We were talking about
Firewatch.
Yeah.
And how you talk to Delilah and how the different things that you
say can change the story.
Say can change the story and how they interact with each other.
Which, you know what that reminds me of?
Because they bring it up. How long is it? It's 79 days or something that they spend out there?
Yeah, 79 days.
And so it doesn't, you're not playing every single day.
Oh, no.
It goes from like, you know, day one to day two to day three to day like 14. 15. And then it goes to
day 77.
Yeah. And it goes to like, it goes to like day 77. And then, but the last 3 days you play.
Yeah.
You play through like the last three.
Yeah.
77, 78, 79.
Yeah.
And that like gets up. That's your intense, you know, part of the game.
The ending.
The ending. But as far as the landscape of this park is gorgeous.
Yeah.
The gameplay is simple.
Yeah. Easy for anyone to do. I could have played it.
It's not like you can lose.
Yeah.
So
there's nothing to try and kill you.
You cannot fall off of a cliff. You know, you can't if he's climbing, he's going to go all the way to the top. You know, anybody could play the game.
Yeah.
It's the game is all
about
dependent.
The storyline.
It's really about the story and about the experience of that game.
I will say they've all gone. Bless it.
What?
They've all gone to...
Everybody's gone to the Rapture.
Yeah, which is very... It's very similar. There's no way you can lose.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing trying to kill you.
Mm-hmm. But Everybody's Gone to the Rapture is different in that you don't know who you are.
No.
Like, you don't know...
You don't know your character.
You do not know your character.
You don't know how you're related to anybody.
Yeah.
It's
kind of like watching a movie.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody's Gone to the Rapture. The big thing about that one is it's got this really, really cool mechanic.
Yeah.
Where they have these glowing, like, orbs.
The light.
These
they
light.
They call it the light.
And you go up to these, you know, little balls of light, mm-hmm. and you interact with the balls of light, and those... tell you something about the story that's going on. What the hell are you doing, dog? There's no chicken up there.
I don't think she wants chicken. I think she wants biscuit.
Oh my god, she freaking stole your biscuit off of your plate earlier today.
Yeah.
Oh my god, freaking dog.
Half a biscuit.
Yeah.
Just gone.
Gone. Sometimes she's like really, really good about it. She won't beg at
she's
all.
Not interested.
And then other days she's like, I need all of your food. Hand it over. What the hell, dog? She's weird. And then she won't eat her fucking dog food.
She won't eat
days.
Her food.
Like, you give her dog food, and she's like, no, I'm going to beg for yours all day long.
Yeah.
Weirdo. I blame you. It's all your fault.
Why is it my fault?
It's all your fault.
I don't give her treats. I was not the one treating her with biscuit.
All right, guilty as charged.
Yeah.
But the Everybody's Gone to the Rapture is pretty cool. It takes place in a... in a little English town.
Yeah.
It's a small little, there's a farming village right outside of it. There's a bunch of farms that are around, and there's an observatory in there where they do, like, some crazy experiments and whatnot.
Which you don't really know.
Yeah, you don't know exactly what they're doing. You kind of figure out that they came in contact with these...
life
you know,
forms.
You figure out that the light is actually they are life forms. They're some sort of energy, they I think that they take the energy from the people mm-hmm. in there, and then they are able to manifest into this light.
Yeah,
and the energy that they take when you interact with the light,
mm-hmm.
It's not like it. Shows you exactly what the people looked like.
No.
Everything darkens around mm-hmm. and
it just kind of swirls in where they were standing.
Yeah, there's like little light
swirly dudes.
Almost looks like streamers, kind of.
Or tornadoes.
Or like a little tornado of light. And then every time they talk, there's little light particles that glow. And
so you can kind of see the outline.
So you can see the outline of the person, but you don't know what they look like. You only know what they sound like, which is incredible.
Yeah.
Now the only person that you figure out that they have a
different look
is the main characters.
It's one of the main characters. And her name is Kate.
Kate. She's the one that really looks into these life forms and tries to understand them. And we find out that she's actually, she's black.
Yes.
And this area of England, they hadn't gone through the same things that America had gone through. And this is like, this is shortly after World War II, like maybe 20 years or so, I think is what is happening at the same time the civil rights movement is happening in America. That is the time period that I kind of got out of it. No, but then they have computers, right?
They have.
And transistor radios, so it can't be the 60s.
Maybe it's the 70s, 80s?
Maybe it's
90s?
Early 80s? I don't know if they would, but maybe it's just because it's a small town in England that they have some reservations about black people in there?
Maybe.
I don't know. I can't figure out the freaking timeline in that game.
No, I couldn't figure out when it was or exactly where it was.
Yeah. I can't figure
out where. Like, you know it's in England. Mm-hmm. But
because everybody has an English accent.
And the signs.
Yeah, all the signs are.
The way they're made, they look like English signs. Mm-hmm. They don't look like American signs.
Right.
But the interesting about that is how. Like, it completely passed over me. You had to explain that to me.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't that I wasn't paying attention. It was just the fact that I took the sentences differently than you did.
Also, Kate's American as well.
Yes.
She's the only American.
Yes.
So not only that, she's American and she's black.
Yes. And because there's one of the characters said something about how her type doesn't belong here.
Mm-hmm.
And in my mind, that meant an American educated woman.
Yeah. Well, normally, if.
And that's the way I took it.
Well.
It completely passed over me that, that means she's black.
It passed over me as well. I didn't sit there and go, oh, she's black. Like, that doesn't.
No, it didn't make sense to me.
The hinting at it when she was so. When the mother was like so prejudiced against her, I'm like, there's got to be something else. She's got to have like, she's got to be of, she's got to be like black or Latina or something like that. Mm-hmm. I was like, there's no way that she's like, she doesn't look like us was one of the thing. I'm like, oh, okay. Well, if she doesn't look like you, then she's probably a person of color. And then, there was an interaction between Kate and Steven, the other guy, his like old ex-girlfriend that he was like having an affair with while being with Kate.
Yeah. Ugh. And Kate knew it too.
Yeah. Kate knew it too.
The way she handled that. Damn.
Classy. But they had a conversation near the end of the game where she's like, oh yeah, I know that you're dating Steven. No, I hope you don't know. It's fine with me and all that crap.
Yeah.
And she's like, well, why wouldn't it be fine with you? You're not with him. Is it because of my skin color? And I was like, there you go. I finally got it.
Mm-hmm.
That was definitive
proof.
At least that's what I remember. Because after we were talking about it, I was like, I'm pretty sure she said that she was black at that point. So,
and like, I was kind of like,
but you didn't catch that. So I'm like, am I imagining this?
Or I don't like, I didn't catch the fact that she said anything about skin color.
Yeah.
And the way I caught it was that she was saying, is it because I'm American? And like, that's how I remember the situation going down.
I thought it might have been, an American thing or whatnot. Is but it, then Yeah. The big kicker was like, she doesn't look like us.
She doesn't look like us.
That was the big one.
Yeah, that was one of the major ones. That she doesn't look like us.
I haven't looked up anything. I'm just assuming that she's black, but
we'd have to really look that up.
I'm just saying, like, an American in that time woman saying that she doesn't look like us. I'm not thinking that she's an Asian. She's of Asian descent or anything like that.
Yeah.
She's more than likely black.
She could be Asian. She could be Latina.
But I love.
But she doesn't look.
I really, really liked like that they put that in there, though.
Yeah.
It was a really, really cool dynamic. It was, and it really, really it does really, really cool things by the end of the end of the game too, and how Kate is and how she reacts to everything is way cool.
Oh yeah.
She's a really interesting. She is my favorite character in the game. She,
like, at first I didn't like her.
Yeah, I thought that she was kind of standoffish.
That not just that she was standoffish, but she was cold.
Yeah, and then
she.
But it, as you sit there and you go, oh, okay, you know,
it's not just her fault.
They were treating her poorly in here.
Yeah.
You know, they treated her like an outsider, even though she was just as smart, if not smarter, than Steven. You know, and they weren't giving her, you know, the respect or the chance that she deserved or that she wanted.
Yeah.
I think she probably felt out of place because Steven brought her back home.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah, I can understand that.
Oh
shit.
Yeah.
It was unfortunate for her. But by the end of the game,
I thought she was just a badass. Awesome.
What she figures out, what she finds out to do is just it's pretty cool. I would definitely pick that one up.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, you know, if you're a PS Plus subscriber, if you're a PS Plus subscriber and you're not just downloading every game. I don't download every game. I just, like, you know, quote unquote purchase it. I go on store.playstation.com and I just click the
say yes.
I just add to cart and confirm the purchase.
Yeah.
And then so it just sits on my library on the PlayStation. Mm-hmm. Doesn't actually have to download. Yeah. Now there's some games like Everybody's Gone to the Rapture where I sit there and just hit the download button and then it's wait for me when I get home. It's awesome.
You know, I was going to bring this up. Another indie game that I adore and is very near and dear to my heart, Undertale.
Yeah, and this is what I'm getting at with these cool. You don't have to have.
You don't have to have much to be a fantastic game.
You don't have to have, you know, stunning graphics, or like riveting gameplay.
No.
Because
it can be very simple.
The best part about Undertale is the story behind it, and that's why I liked other people playing it. I do not like the gameplay.
You don't like Bullet Hells.
It did not go over.
The other part that I other game that I'm going to bring up really quickly is Stanley Parable and Five Nights at Freddy's.
Yeah, and this is what I'm saying with these indie games is that you get, you know, completely different.
Oh yeah.
Experiences out of these games.
Oh yeah, like the reason I bring up Stanley Parable, just like Undertale, you get to choose and you kind of choose your own adventure.
Yeah,
and then FNAF created an entire genre.
Yeah, I mean, granted, it's a very, very,
very precise genre.
Yeah,
X location haunted, where main character is being attacked by animatronics.
Yeah. I mean, they made, you know, tons of fan games off of there.
Fan games off of it. But the original ones are fantastic.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
And not just that, but they're steeped in lore and story that if you're not paying attention, you're going to miss.
Yeah.
And even
like
though
there was,
I want to play it so badly.
You know, with Everybody's Gone to the Rapture, we missed a lot of the storyline.
Oh, yeah, we did.
That I didn't even know was there, and I thought that I was really exploring a lot to try and find these things, and I was like, holy crap, like, I may have not even hit 50% of it.
No.
So,
we missed so much of that story.
And, you know, with games like Gone Home and things of that nature, they're able to attack different different things. Yep. And when you look at other indie games, such as like That Dragon Cancer, you get to experience these things that people sit there and they go, you know, I want to make a game. I want to sit there. I want other people to experience this because when you were sitting there with a controller and you're actually controlling, you are actually manipulating this world that they have put you in. It gives you a whole nother outlook on the story and how and everything. It's quite incredible.
Yeah.
And the great thing is that with movies, you know, with books, they have to tell a story.
Yeah.
With movies, there has to be dialogue.
Yes.
There has to be
dialogue, action.
You know.
Movement.
There has to be, you know, certain character arcs. Whereas you play inside, you don't know what's happening. All you're doing is playing.
Yeah. All you're doing is moving forward. Trying
to figure this out. And where.
Firewatch.
In Firewatch, well, I mean, there is dialogue, and dialogue is great, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
The voice acting in that is
fantastic. But
it puts a whole nother emphasis on it when you are creating that story.
Yes.
When you are actually part of that story. I think that it's and I really, really hope that we can continue.
I would love it. Because to me it looks like games are becoming another art form.
Yeah.
And it's becoming something.
I mean, I've always thought that they were.
Oh no, I've always thought that, but it's a way for people to share something, and share it in a totally different way.
Yeah, it just gives you another avenue.
It gives you it's not a video. It's not a book. It's something that you can create and grow with yourself.
Yeah, and that's why, you know, when people talk about creating, you know, taking video games and making them into movies or making them into books or something. I'm sitting there like, do you need to do that? They're games. Leave them as games.
Leave them as a game. I will say there are a couple times that works.
Like Uncharted 4. I couldn't imagine that.
As a movie.
Because you wouldn't get half of that story in there.
No.
And the things like when you sit down with Sam and you talk to him about you can choose to sit there and talk to him, or you can choose to get up and not have that conversation with him. And that's the thing that I'm talking about. You can choose to have these different.
Yeah.
These
different. You can choose to have a different experience than someone else. There are a couple times in Firewatch that I said, do this.
And I went.
It was my choice.
And
you totally did the opposite. Yeah. And I was like, why would you do that?
Because I didn't feel the way that I was playing him. I just didn't feel like he would say that.
Yeah.
You know,
like
the
you
way
chose
that
the beagle. I chose the German Shepherd.
Yeah. And I was like, no, I'm going to choose the beagle. I was like, that's because she wanted the beagle.
Yeah.
You know, your character wanted the German Shepherd, but she wanted the beagle. And I was like, I really think that we need to choose the dog that she wanted.
Yeah.
And then afterwards, it sit there and goes, you know, after a month, you forgot about the other dog, and the beagle was the only thing you could think about. And I'm like, see, it worked out.
Yeah.
You know, but she might have not been able to get over it.
Yeah.
You don't know.
No.
There's your thing. So.
But it's very interesting how
that
might
have been a thing, you know, when she got dementia and whatnot, to be like, you know, you didn't let me have the dog that I wanted.
Know?
Could have been
an actual argument. So. But like even, God, I'm trying to think of another one. Like in Undertale, you can choose to do so much.
Yeah. You can choose to kill everybody.
You can choose to kill everyone. You can choose to kill
nobody.
No one. You can go an intermediate route.
Kill some and.
Kill some, spare others.
Yeah.
But it's. Like, if you choose to go normal RPG, you're going a neutral route. Because you're going to farm, you're going to do all this stupid shit that I hate in RPGs sometimes.
Grind.
Whatever.
I do not know why Markiplier calls it farm.
Shut up!
It's called grind.
Shut up. You Claude.
Are you going anywhere with this
thought? No, what I was saying is, because, like, normal RPG... you play and you kill stuff. Mm-hmm. That's just what you do. And then there's also a way to play that you just kill everything. And I don't want to ruin it because that route really turns you into a monster.
Yeah. But that's the point.
And that's the point.
You know.
Which is so weird when you play a normal RPG.
Yeah, because Toby Fox wanted you to experience the game in these different ways.
Oh, yeah.
So in like, if you chose to do this, this is going to be your story.
Yeah.
And if you choose to do this, this is going to be your story. Yeah. And if you choose to do that, that's going to be your story. It's really quite incredible.
And if you play like I did and just go straight out pacifist, which is the way I would choose to play anyway, mm-hmm. even if the game hadn't been spoiled for me previously, because I don't like, if I can talk my way out of something, I'll talk my way out. That's just who I am. But to have that as a choice in a game and have it actually affect it blew me away.
Yeah.
It made me, when I finally got to the end of the true pacifist route, you know, I was bawling like a baby.
Yeah.
I was trying to finish a bullet hell crying, saying, fuck you, game. How am I supposed to do this?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's definitely quite something.
Or like in Stanley Parable, well, everything's a joke.
Yeah.
Everything is a parody upon itself and upon game tropes. And it's just, like, that one's just plain out fun.
Yeah. All right.
So.
Well, everybody, this was...
I will end by saying I love indie games.
Yeah.
So.
That was the point. All right, everybody, this was I Love You.
I know.
And this is the signature podcast from the Prolonged Engagement. You can go to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/theprolongedengagementshow. You can also go to our website, theprolongedengagement.com. There you can find links to our YouTube channel and to all the podcasting services that we're on. You can find this show every Monday at noon on YouTube as well as podcasting services around the globe. As always, thank you guys for watching, and we will see you next week.
Bye-bye!
Hey guys, thanks for watching. And if you want to subscribe, you should click over here. If you want to watch the latest episode of I Love You, I Know, click right here.
If you want to see our latest video, click right here. And if you want to see our latest Let's Play, click right here.
If you're listening on MP3,